Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'd like to talk about anti-Parkinson drugs. So when we're talking about anti-Parkinson drugs, we need to understand basically what is Parkinson's disease. So Parkinson's disease is nothing but it is a decreased dopamine concentration. What is it? Decreased dopamine concentration in the central nervous system. So for that, we need to understand where is our dopamine produced. In central nervous system, dopamine is majorly produced from which part? Dopamine is majorly produced from, that is our substantia nigra. Now you might ask, is it only substantia nigra which produces dopamine? No, there are other places dopamine is produced from the neurons. But the thing is, if there is a decrease of dopamine in the substantia nigra, will lead to a disease called, what is that? Parkinson's disease. Now Parkinson's disease, the patients will have uncontrolled resting tremors, they will have problems with the movements because the whatever signal which was supposed to, inhibitory signal which was supposed to come to the periphery is not coming just because of deficiency of dopamine. So all our target is to increase the dopamine in the central nervous system to decrease the symptoms. So this is our target to treat the patient with the Parkinson's disease. So let's start. How can we increase the dopamine concentration in the central nervous system? Okay, so for that, let's start. We have a neuron, postsynaptic membrane. Okay, so we have our blood-brain barrier. Why I'm talking about blood-brain barrier, you'll understand in 1 minute. What is our problem? The problem in a Parkinson patient is very, very simple. What is that? The simple problem is dopamine deficiency. You might ask me, you have dopamine available in the laboratory, just take the dopamine and inject to that patient. Okay, now dopamine was manufactured in something called levodopa. Now levodopa is similar to that of dopa and injected into the patient veins. Now when I injected the levodopa or dopa into the patient vein, what happened in the periphery? See, this is our central nervous system, this is periphery. This levodopa was broken down into some degraded products by an enzyme called dopa decarboxylase. What is the dopa decarboxylase? Where this process is happening? It is happening in the peripheral. Yes or no? So it is peripheral dopa decarboxylase break the levodopa or dopamine, whatever we give to the patient. So what is happening? That broke levodopa into what? For example, let's keep here dopamine itself. Okay. It broke into dopamine itself, or if I give dopamine, it was causing the decarboxylation. When I have dopamine elevated in the periphery, what will happen? It will have action on the heart, it would increase the heart rate, it might cause the vasodilation in the kidneys as well as in the mesentery. All those was a problem, and still our purpose of increasing the dopamine in the central nervous system was not achieved. Okay, so this is one aspect. Okay, let's keep it here and let's come back to our nerve. When we come back to our neuron, very simple thing, pay attention. How does dopamine form? Dopamine is formed from the amino acid of tyrosine. Tyrosine was converted into all those steps, and at the end of the day, it was converting into dopamine. Dopamine was stored in the granules. When a signal comes, it used to get released, and it used to act on the D2 receptor, that is dopamine 2 receptor. Yes or no? When a signal comes, or presynaptic calcium channel opens, calcium ion comes in, it will cause the exocytosis of the dopamine, and it used to work on the dopamine receptor. This is how it has been working. Okay, now why we need to understand this? Because to treat the person, we need to increase dopamine. So to increase dopamine, we need to know how dopamine is formed. So let's see how we can make this levodopa reach there, or how we can increase the dopa. Okay, clear till now? So what is our target? To increase the dopa, make this levodopa go into the, cross the blood brain barrier and go to the central nervous system. Now here I want to talk is, dopamine is metabolized by two enzymes. One is called COMT and one more is called as MAO, that is monoamino oxidase. What is COMT? Catechol-O-methyltransferase. What is COMT? Catechol-O-methyltransferase. It is an enzyme which breaks not just dopamine, it also breaks adrenaline and noradrenaline. Now MAO, what is MAO? We already know that is monoamino oxidase. monoamino oxidase has two types, monoamino oxidase A and monoamino oxidase B. B is the one which is responsible for the breaking down of dopamine. So dopamine is broken by which MAO? That is our MAO B, that is monoamino oxidase B. Now our target is what? Either inhibit this guy or inhibit this guy. If I inhibit this guy, dopamine will increase. Inhibit this guy, dopamine will increase. Or directly stimulate this guy. Who is this guy? That is our dopamine receptor that will work or make the levodopa cross the blood-brain barrier and get into the central nervous system. So this how we can treat the patient. So let's see the drugs now. So when we want to see the drugs, I want to remove this part. I hope you understood about the levodopa. Now let's see what are the things we can do. First thing, I told we can give dopa directly. Sorry, not dopa, that is our dopamine directly. But dopamine was unable to cross the blood-brain barrier. So when dopamine was unable to cross the blood-brain barrier, I made something called levodopa. Now what is levodopa? Levodopa can cross the blood-brain barrier, but I earlier told levodopa was metabolized by dopa decarboxylase in the periphery. So now what I have to do is I have to inhibit this dopa decarboxylase in the periphery. That process is done by whom? Carbidopa. Now what happens if I put a carbidopa? What carbidopa does? It will inhibit, what is that? Dopa decarboxylase enzyme in the periphery. Okay, so when I inhibit dopa decarboxylase in the periphery, what will happen? No breakdown of the levodopa. Now levodopa, for example, levodopa was here. I don't have this enzyme and it will cross the blood-brain barrier and come to the CNS very easily. So this is about levodopa and carbidopa. Now levodopa and carbidopa, they are not preferred in the patient who is young and diagnosed with the Parkinson. It is preferred in the old patients. Okay, so this is about our levodopa, carbidopa. Let's go back to the story of our monoamino oxidase and our COMT. Let's see about our monoamino oxidase. I told MAO B, monoamino oxidase B, was the enzyme which was responsible for the breakdown of dopamine, right? So I can inhibit this enzyme, right? So that will be MAO B inhibitors. What are those? Monoamino oxidase B inhibitor. Monoamino oxidase B is the enzyme responsible for what? Responsible for the breakdown of the dopamine. And next thing I wanted to tell is monoamino oxidase A. Monoamino oxidase A is a enzyme which is responsible for the breakdown of our what? Our serotonin. Okay. Now let's see MAO B inhibitor, that is selegiline and rosagiline. So these are the two drugs. What they do is they inhibit MAO B. When I inhibit MAO B, dopamine concentration is elevated and our Parkinson patient is being treated. This is one way to treat the patient. Now I told dopamine was metabolized by one more enzyme. Which was that enzyme? That is our COMT. Now COMT inhibitor. What are those? COMT inhibitor. COMT inhibitor. When we are talking about COMT, what that is? Catechol-O-methyltransferase inhibitor. So we have one drug called as entinacap. Entinacapone. That is our drug which we use for the treatment of our Parkinson patient. So these are the two groups. Apart from these, we have one more way. I told we can directly stimulate what? We can directly stimulate the dopamine receptor. That directly dopamine. So that is dopamine agonist. Dopamine agonist. What does agonist mean? We already know agonist means stimulant. We have one drug that is bromocriptine. Bromocriptine. Now bromocriptine is what? Bromocriptine is a ergot derivative. Bromocriptine is what? It is a ergot derivative which will directly stimulate the dopamine receptor, which could be used in the treatment of Parkinson patient. But bromocriptine, apart from the Parkinson as a use. We have other uses such as treatment of prolactinoma. We use it in the treatment of craniopharyngioma. Almost many of the central nervous system tumors, the only reason is this bromocriptine drug, when we use it in the patients, what will happen is it will shrink the size of the tumor. Maybe, for example, tumor was not possible to operate earlier. By using the bromocriptine, we decrease the size and we will be able to operate it now. So that is the use of a bromocriptine apart from the Parkinson's disease. So we are done with these things, and we have one last important thing. It's a fact and you need to remember the drug amantadine. Now, don't get confused or don't think that I'm speaking something wrong. Amantadine is what? Amantadine is an antiviral drug. Still, amantadine, unknown mechanism, has some effect. It will increase the dopamine. Amantadine does what? Increase the dopamine concentration in the central nervous system, especially in the neurons. What exactly it does is it increases the release of the dopamine, but how exactly we didn't know, and that amantadine is approved drug for the treatment of Parkinson patient. So all our target was what? Our target was to increase the dopamine. How we can increase? Let's summarize everything very simply. We can directly give dopamine. So instead of dopamine, we gave levodopa. Levodopa was not able to cross the blood-brain barrier, so we inhibited levodopa was able to cross the blood-brain barrier, but dopamine was not able to cross. I'm sorry about that. Dopamine is not able to cross. Levodopa is able to cross the blood-brain barrier. So we gave levodopa, but it could be metabolized in the periphery by whom? Dopa decarboxylase. So we need to inhibit dopa decarboxylase. We added carbidopa. Levodopa and carbidopa is a combination used most preferably in the elder patient. Apart from that, we have our MAO-B inhibitor, that is monoamine oxidase B inhibitor, and we have our COMT inhibitor, and we have dopamine agonist, and we have amantadine. Amantadine is what? It's antiviral, but still it is an approved drug for the treatment of Parkinson patients. Thank you guys, keep watching. Thank you very much.